Hello everybody, in this video I'm going to show you how to use Canva's latest new feature, element timings.
Until now you've been able to add an animation to an element and choose whether the animation begins at the start of a page, at the end or both.
Now with new element timings you can control when an element such as text appears on your page and for how long. Add animations to elements in the usual way and then build a sequence so that they appear on your page one by one. So if you create presentations and you want to learn how to have bullet points appear on your page one by one underneath each other, this is exactly the method you need to use. Element timings are available on desktop and mobile and are really easy to set up. You don't need Canva Pro for this tutorial, but if you would like to take your graphics to the next level, add music from the Canva library, and even test out the exciting video background removal tool, then click on the link which I will leave in the description box underneath. Okay, so if you're ready to start making scroll-stopping, eye-popping graphics, follow me over to my Canva desktop.
The first thing to remember is that you will need a video template. So from your Canva homepage, go up to this search bar here and click on the little video icon. And this will bring up all the different video templates underneath. You can use any of these size templates, but I'm going to use my usual presentation size since it suits the YouTube video best. So I'm just going to click on it to open it up. And of course, you already know by now how this works. To find a template that suits your project, use these search categories underneath, which are all clickable. Use the side arrow to scroll through the various categories, or you can type in the search bar exactly what you're looking for. I've already got a template loaded up onto my dashboard, so I'm just going to click on that to open it up. You don't need to use multiple page documents, but if you do, you'll be able to view all the thumbnails right at the bottom here. And this is your video timeline. On the left-hand side, you have your play button, and the playhead is right here with this little inverted triangle right at the top. You can move it along the timeline by grabbing a hold of it with your cursor and moving it from side to side. And here's a quick tip to make editing a lot easier. You might want to zoom in on the video timeline. To do this, you'll need to go right down to the bottom right-hand corner of your page until you see this really tiny icon. So at the minute, we're in zoom page mode. So if I grab a hold of this little button here and slide it along the slider bar, you can see I can zoom out of a page and back in again. What I want to do is zoom in on the video timeline, because as you can see, I'm using teeny tiny thumbnails and it's a little bit difficult to see. So I'm going to go back to this little icon here and click on it so that I'm now in zoom thumbnails. So if I slide this little button along the slider bar, you can see what happens. It increases the size of my thumbnails, and that is much easier to work in. Okay, the second step is to start adding all the elements to your template. You can see I've already added some text overlay. So I've got a heading here, a subheading. I've got this lovely mobile phone frame in which I've placed a video. And of course, I've changed the colour of my background. Once you've added all the elements to your page, you can start adding animations if you want. If you're unsure how to do this, I'll leave a link to my Canva animations tutorial in the description box underneath this video so you can check it out later. You don't have to use animations, but I do think if you're going to be using it for business, it'll make your graphics so much more engaging and eye-catching. To add an animation to text, select it with your cursor, go up to the Animate button in your Canva toolbar and click on it. And this will bring up a whole menu of text animations. If you don't know what an animation looks like or how it will affect your text, just hover your cursor over the little thumbnail. So I'm going to add the wipe animation to this text. And I want to apply it at the start of my page, so I'll click on Enter. The speed is just right as it is, but if you want to change the speed, just grab a hold of this little button here and slide it along the slider bar. I'm quite happy with the direction of the animation, so I'm going to leave it as it is. And I'm going to animate the subtitle as well. It's not just text you can animate anything on your page. So stickers, photographs. So I'm going to add an animation to this lovely photo frame here. Fantastic. When you're adding animations to your page, always check to see what they look like on the screen on the right-hand side. Now for the exciting and important step. You're going to add the timings to your elements. First of all, I'm going to select all the elements on my page by holding my cursor down, sweeping it over the page to select all the elements. And I can let go of my cursor now. You'll see that each individual element has a purple outline to it. And the group of elements is surrounded by a dotted white line, and that means that those elements have been selected. The next step is to hold your trackpad down and press Control at the same time. And this will bring up a menu of editing options. Go down until you find Show Timing. Click on it. Now look on the video timeline and you have an extra line over the top of your video timeline, and this is called the element timeline. To expand the element timeline, click on this little upward arrow here. And now you can see all the different elements that you have on your page. So I have a video element within the mobile phone mock-up. I have a line of text, and you can see it's outlined in purple as I select it. And I have a subheading. To build a sequence of elements onto your page, you need to decide which one you want to introduce first on your page. So I want my heading to appear first, then the subheading, and then the little video. To build a sequence, go back down to the element timeline and click on the element that you want to appear first. Hover your cursor over the sidebar of that element until it turns into an arrow. Hold your cursor down and then drag the sidebar into position. So I want my main heading to appear 0.2 seconds after the page begins. Next, I want my subheading to appear after the main heading. So I'll repeat this process. Select the subheading in the element timeline. Hover the cursor over the end bar and then drag it into position. So I want the subheading to appear 0.5 seconds after the page starts. And I'm going to do the same for the little video as well. So I've now built my sequence of elements. You can test out your sequence by dragging the timeline to the start of your page and then pressing play. Fantastic, so that worked. Once you know how to adjust these settings, you can apply this process to anything on your template except the background. I'm going to run through that process once more with this page, just so that you're absolutely crystal clear what needs to be done. Select all the elements, show timing, expand the element timeline, choose your sequence, hold down the sidebar and drag into place. Drag the playhead to the start of the page and review your page. Finish setting up all your lovely element sequences, you can now make full use of the Canva video editor by adding music from the Canva library. Just drag and drop your chosen track onto the video timeline. Now finish off your project with some truly beautiful and professional transitions.
If you're unsure how to add music to a template or use Canva transitions, you'll find links to my video tutorials in the description box underneath this video. If you're unsure about how to use Canva animations properly, and there have been some new developments recently, check out this video right here and I will walk you through step by step. In the meantime, have fun, give this video a thumbs up to support my channel, and I will see you in the next video.